You've been hearing a lot about Microsoft Fabric and the era of AI and the MVP program. Learn all about those things, plus how becoming a super user might help you this week on Data Exposed MVP Edition. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed MVP Edition. Today, we have a special episode where I'm joined by Microsoft's Ree Merritt. Ree, thanks so much for coming on Data Exposed.
Awesome. Thanks for having me. I appreciate it. It's good to be here.
It's great to have you, and we really appreciate all that you do for our community and the MVP program, which is conveniently what we're going to talk about today. So let's kick it off. Tell us, like, what is this MVP program?
So the MVP program actually just celebrated its 30th year. So earlier in 2023, 30 years in existence. It is a program that's sponsored by Microsoft that connects technical community leaders with the Microsoft product group. They promote engagement, advocacy, and knowledge sharing about Microsoft products and services. So, there are MVPs that are awarded across a lot of different categories in the Microsoft vertical, right? So it's data platform, dev technologies, AI, Azure, security, tons of different stuff. And I think right now there are just under 4,000 globally.
Wow. I had no idea there were that many. I guess because most of the time I'm thinking about like data MVPs, but it's so much bigger than that, right?
Yeah, it is. And data MVPs right now, we have about 360 active data platform MVPs out there.
So we know a little bit about like the program, but who actually are these MVPs? Who are these people that kind of represent?
Right. So MVPs are technology experts capable of really, really deep dives into the data platform, all aspects of it, our products, solutions, and they take that knowledge, use it to solve real world problems, but then they share that knowledge with the public. So they are the ones that you see speaking at large conferences. They're the blogs that you read when you're trying to solve a problem. They are the ones answering questions on forums. I think you follow them on Twitter. You probably follow them on LinkedIn, because they're constantly sharing information with the public about, you know, and educating people on the intricacies that are everything that falls under Azure data.
Yeah, awesome. I see them kind of like the lifeblood of our community, but also like they bring so much to the product group, to, again, the community and to customers. So, you know, obviously we're super grateful from Microsoft's view for these MVPs. And even this MVP edition, this was spun up to bring that experience that the MVPs have and share it out broader. So
absolutely. And MVPs love participating in Data Exposed. They love it.
Well, you know, we're always happy to have them, and it's a lot of fun. And I think like the MVPs are super valuable also just in supporting each other, like you mentioned, like the hashtag SQL Help and SQL Family, like everyone's there to support each other. So they're awesome. Now, what if you're like, what if you want to be an MVP? Like, how does that work?
So it's simple, but it's not simple, right? Three steps. Be an expert, right? Do lots of what you love for the community, and then let us know about it. So MVPs are recognized speakers and presenters. They're technical content creators of blogs. They write books. They're technical community leaders. So they probably organize your user group or a conference that you attend. And they're advocates on social media, tons of different things that they can do. You can be nominated to be an MVP by any existing MVP or by a Microsoft FTE. And once you're nominated, there's this whole backend portal process that you go through where you submit all of your activities. So how many times did you present last year? How many blogs did you publish last year? You know, did you write a book? Did you mentor anyone? Things like that. You would go and put that in the portal. You would help us track how many people viewed your YouTube channel in the last year, because that's going to help us assess your reach and your impact. It's going to help you make the case for all the stuff that you do out in the community. So once you're nominated, you complete that profile. And we have a team of people who review it, confirm it, make sure you really did speak at that conference, make sure you really did post that blog, make sure your YouTube channel really does have that amount of activity, things like that. And then we make a decision and an assessment. I often explain that it's more art, or it's as much art as it is science, because we do compare people across the program. But not totally. I mean, I compare or look at an MVP from Sri Lanka sort of in a different way where I would an MVP from New York City, right? Because they have different opportunities. MVPs who the bulk of their activity is in a language that's not English have different opportunities to present. But they also, in a lot of cases, if they're blogging in Greek, if they're blogging in Spanish, they're delivering content to an underserved audience, right? Versus an MVP who's delivering content in English. So it's there is no checklist I can give you, but we do try to look at what it is that they're bringing to the community, and are they filling a gap in the program as we evaluate MVPs each month.
Absolutely, that makes sense. And I got to ask, because now I'm more curious than anything. I'm sure other people are too. Like, are there certain activities that get you more points, or like, are there things that you would encourage people to do if they want to become an MVP? Like, how do they think about like what they should prioritize or how to get started?
So what I tell everybody is to do what you love and the award will follow, because there isn't, and even if I could answer that question, it would change in 6 months, right? Because do I have a ton of MVPs who are doing something right now on Power BI, and do I not have enough MVPs who are doing Azure Cosmos or PostgreSQL? And so on any given month or quarter or year, I might look at the program and go, oh, we're a little off balance. So let me look for, you know, people out in the community who are doing Cosmos, who are doing Postgres, because I'm lacking in those. But you can't force it. If CosmosDB or PostgreSQL aren't your thing and you try to go do a bunch of activity, it's going to look really inauthentic, and you're not going to enjoy it. You're going to get into the program, and because that's not your thing, you're not going to be able to maintain it. So do what you love, do what you're good at, and I think the rest of it kind of falls into place.
Okay, got it. That makes sense. Great advice. I love it. The final question I have is, I've been hearing a little bit about super users, but I'm not really familiar actually at all with that program. Can you tell me a little bit about what that is and how it relates to the MVP program?
So I would love to. So I just took over the super users program, and right now they're called Power BI super users, but in the coming months, we're going to be transitioning them to Fabric super users. And so what they are, technical experts that are out in the community who help answer questions that people ask on the Microsoft forums. So community.fabric.microsoft.com is where you would start. There's forums. These people answer questions that users have, help them solve problems, and we keep up with how many questions they answer and if it got marked correct or not correct and how engaged they are. And once or twice a year, we filter through this and award someone the title of super user. And once you're a super user, it's kind of an exclusive club where you get extra access to the product group. We have meetings once or twice a month. They help guide us on changes that we should be making, or improvements we should make on our community platforms, how we can make it easier for them to answer questions for these people. We deliver content to them about the product itself. And most recently, we have this fantastic Learn initiative that's going on, where we're delivering training over a 3-week span. Right now we're in wave one, then wave two, then wave three, for global participation to be able to become a fabric analytics engineer. Certification has been released. And we partnered with MVPs and super users to deliver this content. So they are speaking, they're moderating, they get to attend these sessions with the product group to hear about what's coming, things like that. And perfect segue, in January, two of our super users were awarded the MVP award. So it is a little bit of a stepping stone, because answering questions on our forum or any forum is one of those things that counts as community activity, because you are sharing your knowledge for free with the community. And super users and answering questions on other forums is a way to make that happen. So we work with them a lot, and it's been, so I just took this over in October, and I've learned so much from them already about how all of this works and how people ask and answer questions and different things. Cause when I was an MVP, that wasn't my thing. Like, I didn't answer questions on the forums. So, you know, I didn't really have a perspective into the value of it until today.
Yeah. So. I mean, I think in the era of AI and Microsoft Fabric, we're hearing a lot about both of those things. Both the learning program you mentioned and kind of getting involved in these forums is a great way to kind of dip your toes into community and being a super user and exploring MVP programs. Mm-hmm. So that's awesome. Ree, thanks so much for coming on Data Exposed. For our viewers, we'll definitely put some links in the description for you to learn more, go get involved, come find out about all these different things. We'd love to see you participate. We'd love to hear your feedback on, you know, if you are an MVP, what do you think? And if you've worked with MVPs or you've worked with super users, like, what's your feedback there? Like, we're happy to take all of that. If you like this episode, go ahead and give it a like, subscribe to our channel, and we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.